Hello, everyone, and welcome to the BWC Online Bible Study. My name is Amy Hollis, and we're reading through the Bible a chapter at a time, and then we're coming back together to discuss the things that we've read. We've made it to 1 Thessalonians. Guys, I'm so excited about this. Before you know it, we're going to make it all the way through the Bible. We'll have read the entire Word of God. And I don't want it to be just, oh, I read my chapter for today. I want to take this word personally for myself and apply it to my life. And so as we read this first chapter of Thessalonians, which I'm really excited about Thessalonians because there's some really cool end time stuff we're going to get to talk about. But today we're going to talk about our faith. And how that should be shining out for other people to see. Because that's what Paul talks about in this first chapter. He's talking about how other people from other places are commenting on the faith that the Thessalonian believers had. Now, if you were feeling all frisky and real Bible scholarly, you could scroll back to Acts chapter 17 and read the first part of that. And you'd read about the time when Paul was in Thessalonica and how it is the church got started there because they went there and they told the people about Jesus. And some of them got saved and some of them got angry. You know, as a bold believer in Christ, when you speak the message about God, you should always be speaking it in love. But you should know that there are going to be times when people are not going to like some of the things that you say. That's really hard for me because I want you to like me and I want to like you. Let's be friends. That's how I roll. But the truth is, when we are speaking out the message about Jesus, that crosses paths with a culture that doesn't believe, there are going to be people who are going to get upset. And so we always want to make sure, like I said, that we're speaking this word of God in love, that we're speaking it with compassion and with care. But then if the response that we get in return is not what we expected, that shouldn't stop us from sharing the message about Jesus. Because just like the Apostle Paul, when he was there in Thessalonica and he shared the message about Jesus, the church began there. They ran him out of town. They were trying to kill him. There were people who didn't like what he had to say because it didn't mesh with their culture. But still, he shared the word of God. The seeds were planted and people were saved. Somebody's eternity was affected because he was faithful to do what God asked him to do. And he's commending the Thessalonian believers here, the Thessalonian church, for their faith in the face of persecution. So they continued to preach the message of God, to preach the truth of Jesus, and even in the face of persecution. And people were talking about how they had turned away from this pagan culture and turned toward God. It was something that was really noticed and talked about by other believers. So that's what I want to leave you guys with today. As we read through this word of God together, let's give them something to talk about. Let's let our faith shine. Let's let our love shine. Let's stand boldly and in love speak the message of Jesus in hopes that some of the people are going to be saved, that there are lives that are going to be touched, families, generations, because we were faithful to do what God called us to do. You know, it's one thing just to read the word. It's another thing to do it. But it's even more that we're having a relationship with our sovereign God and our Savior Jesus, and that following the guide, the lead of the Holy Spirit that he's placed on the inside of us so that we can be all that he's called us to be. Let's give him something to talk about. And so I just want to challenge you today to be that light, to show your faith, to show love and care. We're not here to beat people over the head with a Bible just to make them say words that they agree with us. We want to share the love of Jesus. We want to affect a generation. We want to rock a culture with the love of God and the compassion that leads to a repentance and a life that pleases the Lord. Because one day, whether the people know or whether they believe, every knee is going to bow, every tongue's going to confess that Jesus is Lord. And I just want to live my life for Him. And I pray that that some of that's going to rub off on you. I want that for you. I want you to grow in your relationship with God. I want your relationship with God to be something to talk about. And not because we're all that, but because we know the one who is. And so if you like the message today, go ahead and hit the like button. You can share. I'm going to encourage you guys to start doing that, because the more we like and the more we share, the more people see the message about Jesus. I was kind of shy to do that at first because I don't want to ask you to like something, but truth is, it's not about us. It's not about insecurities. It's not about whether or not we think we're good enough. It's about sharing the message of Jesus. And also, if you like the video today, then I know who to be praying for. I know who I'm talking to, and I'll be praying over you. So you guys be blessed. Take care. Give them something to talk about, and I'll catch you back in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2.